iClicker Cloud, the instructor platform that makes it easy to run polling and quizzing sessions, manage grades, and track student attendance. In this video, I'll show you how to run quizzing sessions in class. Before coming to this step, you'll need to create an instructor account, a class, and download the right iClicker Cloud desktop software. Let's get started. You have two options for launching your iClicker Cloud quizzing session. With option one, launch your quizzing session from the instructor website. First, log into your instructor account at the iClicker Cloud website. Click on the course you'd like to run a quiz in. Then click Start Class. Once you've clicked Start Class, click Start Quiz. This will launch the iClicker Cloud desktop software. Your second option is to launch the quizzing session directly from the desktop software. Simply sign in with your instructor credentials, click on the course where you'd like to run your quiz, access the drop-down menu next to Start Polling Session by clicking on this little green arrow, select Start Quizzing Session, and this is the same screen that you would land on if you chose option 1 to start your quiz. Here you can modify the name of the quiz. You'll need to enter the number of questions on your quiz, and here you can say how many points per question. Once you've put in that information, click Start Session. Move your toolbar to a comfortable place on your desktop, and then click Quizzing. Before starting your quiz, be sure to distribute a quiz to your students or display one in your classroom. Quizzing differs from polling in that when running a quizzing session, your students are never sent any screenshots. This prevents students from sharing questions with other classes, and it makes it so that students can work through the quiz at their own pace. I have a quiz to display here. I'm just going to rearrange my desktop so it's easy for me and my students to interact with. And when I'm ready and my students are ready, I click the play button. Now the quiz has started, you can see how much time has passed. You can also see how many of your students have submitted their quizzes. Students are able to move through the quiz at their own pace. If you want more information about where your students are in the quiz process, go ahead and click on the roster button. And you can see here that this student has answered 2 of the 3 questions. If you end a quiz while students are still in progress, iClicker will automatically submit whatever answers the student has already selected. When you can see that many of your students have completed the quiz, you can go ahead and stop it by clicking the stop button. Click yes. And now the quiz is complete. You can now grade the quiz by clicking on the results button. You'll notice that you don't get a screenshot of your questions, so it's good to have the original quiz nearby when you're grading it. So the correct answer to number 1, you cannot ask an audio answer with iClicker. And you can see here that I grade my answers just the same way as I grade my polling questions by touching the correct answer. All right, with number 2, when are iClicker Cloud answers graded? The answer is D after asking a question. And then question number 3, which devices cannot be used by students to answer iClicker Cloud questions? The answer, unfortunately, is flip phones. If you want to give your students some more information, perhaps on how they could do better on the next quiz, you can put some information in here. In order for your students to see this feedback and to see how they answered individual questions and the correct answers for these individual questions, be sure to click this box here. This allows students to view graded results and feedback after the quiz is ended. If you leave this box unchecked, all that students will see is a general score for how they did on the quiz. To learn more about running quizzes with iClicker Cloud, visit the iClicker support site and search for quizzing. Thanks for watching!